made. The type of dreams that they sell you. That's why I learned from my failures. Don't do the handouts or the favors. Told my brother I'ma get this paper. Was left behind, I see.
Hey, I remember sleeping with my ribs done.
EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to First Energy.
They did not want me to go places. Foil plans like the gold place.
And if we pull it up with the whole squad, are you ready? Done told y'all that you better be running. I'm in my goal yard. When I walk in, I know y'all telling me nothing. I'm the man. Sucker if y'all in denial. I get the chip on him and I bust out the south side. Is that Vigo de Gallo?
Boy, yo, stop it, quiet. If it's new, I done got it. See my jewels, shining, shining. White diamonds, Miley Cyrus. Private jet, private pilot. Look at me, stylish, stylish. Masterpiece, bought it, bought it. Young, hey.
We got momentum, don't try to stop it. Diamonds are clearer than my conscience. I don't let bygones be bygones, it's that's when I'm honest. Penthouse building, reach heaven's heights. Now that's what you call a God complex.
Remember the days I was down low when it was out cold, but I went out and got it. Look at my milestones, man, it feel like the Dow Jones when you look at my pocket.
Look at the flex, yeah. Whipping the Teslas.
Ooh,
I'm a mess, girl, I'm a ooh. It's all a finesse.
Boy, yo, stop it, quiet. If it's new, I done got it. See my jewels, shining, shining. White diamonds, Miley Cyrus. Private jet, private pilot. Look at me, stylish, stylish.
Masterpiece, bought it,
young. Hey, I don't know no better, I'm on this every day.
So we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around. It's like the hell in the clock. Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around. Just like the hands on the clock.
Come like a bat of the hell, I dare you to cross like a reverend. And my energy paralyzed, I'm like I'm finger 11. Take a second, I'm finna send it like a parent. A message to the best. If it ain't me, then you need you a confession. You a mess. You ain't scary to me. Heard you was a leader, but that ain't apparent to me. Put dots on you, a cheater, run up and I'm airing the scene. I feel just like Vegeta Prince and I'm an heir to the sea.
I mean, for real. Touch the driver's saw so I don't even grab the wheel. That's a lot on my chest, but it don't mean a man is stealing. Man, I'm walking with some money, man, I mean a couple mil. Ew, think you need a mail. You ain't even eating while I'm feasting in the field. That's why I'm always cheesing, cause I feel like Uncle Phil. And all this losers think the first, but it ain't half the man as well.
Are you irresponsible without your money or not? Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin the block around, just like the hell in the clock.
Are you irresponsible without your money or not?
Thought he had a plan, but we gon' foil his plot. Heard him sneaking in, so we just ran in the spot. And then we spin.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to legendary Lambeau Field in Green Bay. No home team means more to a city than the Packers to Green Bay. And this was the scene a few moments ago as the green and gold made their way out of the historic tunnel. They're ready to go as they get set to match up with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. Mason Crosby of the Packers has it teed up, and off we go from Lambeau. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here right at the 30-yard line.
Take over first and 10 at their own 30-yard line.
So first and 10 now from the 30. Here's Ronald Jones, first carry for the USC man. And he gets this to the 35. Good for a gain of 5. 5 yards on the game's first play. Second down.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
On second down, it's Jones. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. Still a couple yards short of the first as the 3-yard gain brings up the third down.
And it's third down.
Try and run for it with Jones. And Jones is not going to have the first down as they stop him short. No gain on the play there. Nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on fourth. Still a scoreless game in the first, but they're going to go for this thing on their own side of the field on fourth down. They'll go with Jones. And I'm not sure he got there. Did they stop him? They did. A surprising move here on the opening drive of the game. And the Packers are going to get the football back in excellent field position. This is Aaron Jones, and just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up.
Second and 10.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they're able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tuck rule that they can fall back on anymore.
They had the incomplete pass on second down. Now they need a big play here, third and 10. From the gun, it's Rodgers. Gets this to his running back, Aaron Jones. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. 5 yards, not enough. And it'll be fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
Field goal, a 51-yard attempt.
That's leaking to the right, and he missed it by a foot or two. It's no good, and this will remain a scoreless game.
Everything looked good. Good snap, good hold. Sometimes, though, the ball just doesn't want to go where you want it. And this one winds up no good.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And last time they were very fortunate, this offense. They went for it on fourth, turned it over in their own territory. But the other guys held up. They didn't give up any points.
So how about the guy with the number one headset on the sidelines, the head coach? That was planned going into it, not necessarily to not get the first down or to have the defense have to hold up.
But he trusted his defense.
Trusted his defense very much, and I think that that's how he's going to play this game. Go for it, be aggressive, because I've got the Wild Bunch backing me up over here on my own sideline.
Well, we'll see what his offense can do. Second and nine, Brady. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. 22 yards there, a first down.
22 yards.
And I put my first tally mark next to the Brady to Gronk counter here.
I think it may be the first of many, because once they get going, look out, things tend to snowball. Tom Brady trusts Gronk as much as any receiver I think he's thrown to in his career. And it's evident when you see that.
And that's saying something.
That's saying something right there. But he's earned it.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And he won't get much. Maybe a couple. Down inside the 35 to the 34.
At the 34-yard line.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense, rallying to the football and getting him on the ground. But I think the play gets made by the defensive front. Because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
Brady's throw there complete. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
A 3-yard gain on the play brings up third down.
They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all, and now they're looking at third down here. No score after one on EA Sports. Secondary here to try for the third down stop. Shotgun now for Brady. Open man has got one. It's complete. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down. They needed five there on third down. He winds up getting seven.
Buccaneers.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again, second and 10. Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up to throw.
And his throw is going to be incomplete.
The intended target was Chris Godwin, and it's third down.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap. He locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well, and that one's incomplete.
Now play number 7 of the drive as they're looking at a 3rd and 10. Going to be marked down short of the first down, right around the 17. That'll be good for 6, but now it's 4th down.
And there we saw one of the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
They failed once in this spot earlier, but the offense will stay out to go for it on fourth down. Brady to throw for it on fourth down. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Adrian Amos with a pick, and he's going to return it to the 21-yard line.
Brady's pass.
Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one where you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points. No matter what, at worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting three. We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost them.
They'll start out on the ground with Jones. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
First play of the drive. Let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking for the guy carrying the ball. He was the finisher. A really nice run.
Yards the tally on that first down run. Here's second and two. Rodgers with a give. It's Aaron Jones. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. He got maybe a half yard at most, but officially they'll be left with a third and two.
Makes it third and two.
On third down, here's Jones. He finds an opening past the 40. And finally, down at the 41-yard line. 2 minutes on the clock in what's been a scoreless first half. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll take you to Orlando, and Jonathan Coachman. Coach will have highlights and analysis of this first half, one that's featured no touchdowns as of yet on either side.
So his job's a little bit easier for this halftime.
We need to give the coach some highlights here.
Yes, we do.
A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Escaping the pressure right. That's complete to the former Aggie Jay Sternberger. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down. With an extra defender in the secondary now on third down. The first carry now for the BYU man. It's Jamal Williams. And he's going to have a Packers first down by a couple of yards as they're able to get four there on third and two. They're able to convert with a gain of four. Screen. This is Williams. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. It's a gain of 16 and a first down for the green and gold.
They ran that one well. And not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
Scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10.
He's crazy.
They'll run on first down. Jones. 7 yards on the pickup there. They'll leave it with a second and three. Decided to hand it off that time on the run pass option.
Appeared to be an easy decision. Just gave it inside. Nice steady game.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a second and 3.
45.
To throw, it's Rodgers. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
Missed a field goal on their last drive. Here they need something to even get into field goal range on third down.
Here we go. 45 is the mic. Hey, defense. Hey, defense, let's go. 45. Mike, 45. Lynn. Give me that ball, defense. Give me that ball. Inside.
Working from the gun, Rodgers. The Bucs defense stiffens and pushes this to fourth down. So two third down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a third, and now they deal with fourth down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. From the right hash, this from an even 40 yards out. And the 13-year man puts it through. And the Packers are off to a 3-0 lead. Now the drive ends in just 3, but they'll take it. Looks like they'll head to the locker room, barring something unfortunate in front on the scoreboard.
Yeah, they may not be jumping up and down and celebrating because they have the lead, but still, any little momentum in a game like this is important to a team, and they'll feel real good about going in and regrouping, knowing that they are out front.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee, and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And they had a nice little drive going last time through the interception in the red zone. Excellent.
Bad enough to throw it anywhere, but that drives coaches insane when they're thinking about, hey, we got a shot of points already. We're already in a spot where you're thinking you got 3 on the board for sure, and to come over with nothing, that's a really tough one for them to swallow.
Will they make up for it? An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. Throwing again, Brady. Airing this one out for Evans. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left. Evans once again the intended receiver. And it's third down.
Third down. And 10 yards to go.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. From the gun, it's Brady. He's got Evans. And he is going to have a Bucs first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. Brady now on first down. And that is incomplete. Stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go. Mike Evans, the one he was looking for. And it's second down. Brady's incompletion on first down leads to a 2nd and 10. The final shot before half for Brady. Oh, a ball batted in the air, and now it's intercepted. Adrian Amos with a pick. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. And that'll do it for the end of the second quarter. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
These offenses seemingly still back at the hotel for the first half. 3-0 our score as the second half gets underway. Ready to get their next drive underway. Their defense has pitched the shutout. Now they probably need to deliver a little breathing room, maybe make it a two-score game as they've got it first and 10. And he'll get it up near the 35, right at the 34 here. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
2 yards, good enough for first. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
It's a jet sweep. This is Adams. He'll be dropped shy of the 40 despite powering through the tackle. Shaquille Barrett in on the tackle.
Let's just make this one succinct. Nice job there. All 11 guys on defense diagnosing the jet sweep and putting it down.
Off the play fake to Jones. Here's Rodgers. Over the middle, that's caught by Adams. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. We're on 32 on the play. I guess that answers the question of whether or not they're going to try to play conservative and protect this lead in the third quarter.
And I think this is something we're seeing more and more of in the NFL. Teams not playing to protect leads, teams playing to extend them.
On first down. It's Jones, and he'll take this down just shy of the 25-yard line.
Off to Aaron Jones.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
They'll go again to Jones. And a nice run. They're going to take this close to the first down marker at the Bucs' 19-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 7 on the play, and it sets up a third and inches situation. Now a first down carry. It's Williams. And he will get this into the end zone. Touchdown, Green Bay. The 15-yard touchdown run. And the Packers are able to stretch that lead out further. That seemed pretty ideal there for the offense, Charles. You take a little bit of time off the clock here in the third quarter, decent length drive, and you pad your lead as well at the end of it.
And what it does is let you feel like you're in control of this game even more so than a two-touchdown lead, right? Because you've taken that time off, as you noted, which means they couldn't get you off the field. You ran your playbook the way you wanted to, and you gave your defense some rest. What a big-time drive in that situation.
This will be a touchback as that sails over the end line.
25-yard line.
Bucks offense set to begin their next possession. And their halftime hole now even deeper. And they need a big drive here just to answer the first touchdown of the second half scored against them.
They were down at the half. Now, as you mentioned, they're down a little bit bigger, but no time for discouragement.
And he's got daylight. It's a foot race. Past the 20. Touchdown, Tampa Bay.
To number 14,
Chris Godwin. 75 yards. And the Bucs are able to make this a close game again.
On for the point after.
And we didn't even get a chance to settle in for that drive. A quick strike of 75 yards, and they find the end zone.
Don't you get the sense that film study was behind this one, that they saw something that they thought they could take advantage of? The key is calling it in the right situation. Knowing when it exists to go to it, they did exactly that. They've got to feel really good about what they did in advance of this game.
Just looking down at the sideline now, their defense is like, man, can you have strung that out just a few plays? Give us a break. Back out there.
Hey, man, get that water break and get on out there and play.
Fielded a couple yards into the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
At their own 19-yard line.
About set to get this drive started, the Green Bay offense at the line. Their lead down to a field goal now as they start with a first and 10. Now Rodgers. Into heavy traffic and it's intercepted. Carlton Davis picks it, and he's going to get this on down to the 13-yard line. That interception sets them up beautifully already in the red zone.
And you can hear it all the way up here. Oski, everyone turn to block, find a spot, and now they're set up inside the red zone for their offense.
From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Try and get the running game going with Jones. And he'll fight his way down right around the 12. Kenny Clark, the big D tackle there to make the stop.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime means had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, what you pointed out to me at half seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secure before they slide off and try to chip someone at the second level.
And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line.
Antonio Brown.
Brown, his first catch. It's a first down.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up the block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. To throw is Brady. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Tom Brady with a touchdown pass to Chris Godwin. And the Bucs have taken the lead.
I know we often laugh, and sometimes we even exalt the guys who are great trash talkers and give us some really funny lines. But the bottom line is absolute production on the field. The second touchdown of the game, and they lead.
And now they'll be looking to their defense to preserve that lead. And following the touchdown now, it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And he can't field it cleanly. It's loose.
Take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway, and they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
They'll come up now, second and four from the 31. This is Jones. Now calling a gain of three, but not enough to move the sticks. It'll be third and about a foot or two. Pretty good job defensively. Thought he was going to get it, but they knew where that marker was, and they stopped him just short of it.
What it does is emphasize that strategic football and situational football is not just played on the offensive side, is it? Defense understanding, as you noted, where the first down marker was and making sure they didn't get there.
Third and inches, and they've got some extra beef up front. Three tight ends. Here's Rodgers. He's got Adams on the hookup. And he's going to have a Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. It's a gain of 16 and a first down for the green and gold.
First and 10 at the 49-yard line. At the 12-yard line.
They'll run on first down. It's Jones, and not able to break away this time as they're going to stop it right around the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be second down.
And 10 at the Buccaneers' 13-yard line.
Throwing on second down, Rodgers. A crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked off by Lavonte David. The 40. He's at the 30. 10. And it's a pick six. He brings it back to the house for a Buccaneer TD. So a dangerous pass over the middle into zone coverage, and it bit him hard.
And what's really difficult when you throw it in that direction and versus that zone, that means the linebackers have gotten to their spot, gotten their heads back around, and they can see the quarterback and everything in front of them. And they took big advantage of it, went in the other direction, excellent blocking, and picked up a touchdown.
Extra point up and good by Suckup. And that makes it a 21-10 game.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Set to get this drive started. The Green Bay offense at the line. And last time, decent field position through the pick six. Obviously costly.
But they can't afford to just bunker in now. All right? Good field position means go ahead and attack on offense. Try and press the advantage a little bit. They should be better with the football on this possession.
So the last one didn't bother you too much.
No, because it's exactly what you're supposed to do. You can't have good field position and not try to take advantage of it. Sometimes the defense makes a good play, too.
46-yard line.
So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. Rodgers now on first down. The left side completion to Jones. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. That pass play wound up for negative yardage, so here's second and 11.
Watch the twist.
Hey, check Mike 45. Check Mike 45.
shotgun now for Rodgers. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Jones. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
Oh, I came to my feet on that one. I thought he was getting close to breaking that one big. But in the end, give some credit to the defense, finding a way to get to him and forcing a third down.
Again, it's Rodgers. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked up by Jordan Whitehead. And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line.
34-yard line.
The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. They'll try and run some clock now with Jones. And he'll get this up to about the 40. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play.
At the 40-yard line.
Again, it's Jones. And not much room to operate as he'll get this up only to about the 41. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Brady going to throw. That's caught by the big tight end, O.J. Howard. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32.
O.J. Howard.
Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout. As the clock will stop with just 70 seconds left to go in the game. Here's Bradley Pinion now. And surprisingly, this is the first punt of the game for either team. And that'll hit at the 5 and go into the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 20-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And three interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number four is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw four.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown three, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. Rodgers again here on second and 10. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. Devontae Adams, the intended receiver. But now it'll be third down.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. And he will not be able to hang on through the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down.
It's been clear in this matchup which side has been the more physical one. It's been this defense. And here's another example on that last play.
And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out.
45.
They'll go for it. It's Rodgers. And that is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And now possession's going to go over with a football at the 20-yard line. Brady going to throw here. Quick slant to Brown. And the Bucs are going to be looking at first and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal. To throw, it's Brady. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. Tom Brady with a touchdown pass to Chris Godwin as the Buccaneers tack on to their lead. There was no going through the progressions on that touchdown pass.
Yeah, nor was it necessary. His receiver won that route early, presented himself. No reason to wait. Go ahead and put it on him and score a touchdown.
Now Brady. And he's brought down. And this is going to be caught. So add two more to the lead as they continue to pour it on here in the fourth.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
And this one's going to be covered up by the Packers hands team. By the fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number. Kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical. This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They got the lead fourth quarter. Maybe you can expect more passes like that downfield. Back to the air on second down. It's Rodgers. He's going to let it fly. And he backs it away, and it falls down incomplete.
So far on this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
And Adams has it. Good play. And he is going to have the Packers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Green Bay Packers.
One final try now. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. So fire the cannons. It's a victory here for Tampa Bay. And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half to put this one on ice.
And I know a lot of people watching this one were thinking to themselves, I'll bet halftime was really interesting. Probably took the paint off the walls with some of the words that were said. But I get the sense it was much more the adjustments they made. They came in with a game plan that we saw that didn't work in the first half. They made the adjustments necessary, went away from that, and then they got it together, got a spark, and then took off. It's really nice to watch in the second half.
For us, for Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. With that, we say so long, everyone, from Lambeau. We'll be right back.
My hand ain't really no time for luck. Either you got it, you don't. Lie to yourself if you won't. I put my team on my back. Did what I could, what I had. Now I'll be all in my bag. Copy and paste with the swag. Bet you can't do it like me. All my winnings on repeat. Take your L like a boss. Stand 10 toes on your feet. I can never take a loss. I ain't set up for defeat. 4 Giottos on the truck. I had a dream and it stuck. Living my life cause we up. Looking back like where the love. That's why I be hella low key. But contrary to belief, loyalty runs deep. I keep my ear to the streets. Struggle turned me to a beast. I'm off the chain, I'm off the leash. But baby girl, I play for keeps. Told my brother lately, I've been scheming. Against all odds like Willie Beeman. I've been grinding lately, this my season. Lord knows I'm trying to find my reason. Lay it out on the line, ain't no looking back. Giving my all with no strings attached. Came from the bottom, rolls through the cracks. Spotlight on you, boy, you gon' act.
Hey, I remember sleeping with my ribs touched. I remember sleeping with my ribs touched.
The NFL is on EA Sports, and we're at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida. With the echoes of cannon blast still ringing in our ears from the north end zone, the Bucs were introduced a moment ago, and they are all set as their guys will do battle with the Green Bay Packers.
Kickoff for Green Bay.
The veteran kicker Mason Crosby set to do the honors here, and off we go from Tampa. Taken about 7 yards deep, and they will elect to not bring this one out as our first drive will begin. At the
25. Decent game.
He'll come up now, second and four from the 31. Out of the shotgun, it's Jones.
That play reminded me a lot of a former teammate of mine. We used to call him the trash man. His ability to sit through traffic and make plays was uncanny.
And that's exactly what you want from your Mike linebacker. Test. Two plays in. This is third and two. Shotgun now for Brady. Looking for Gronkowski, and he's got him complete. And he is going to have the Buccaneers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Well, they were in search of a short gain on third down, and they wind up nabbing over 20 yards. So into Packer territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. Brady gives his spot to Jones. And he's going to be met at about the 43.
Ball carrier.
2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and eight.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly. That was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
51 the mic, boy. 51. I can't believe they let you get you play. I can't believe they even let you play.
Brady gonna fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. Gronkowski got it on the crossing route. And this is gonna result in another first down as the tackle's made at the Packers 28. A solid gain of 15 yards and the sticks move. So after the run for no gain, here's second and 10. Terrific opening drive has them knocking on the door, first and goal. From the gun, it's Brady. This will be caught at about the five. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. A 9-yard touchdown grab. And the Bucs take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. Quite the drive there to get things started. They took up the bulk of the first quarter, and they end up in the end zone.
And I love your last point. Ended up in the end zone. Because a lot of teams like those long drives, especially to keep their offense off the field, right? Keep the ball away from them. But they finished it with a touchdown. That's the exclamation point. Now flip it over defensively. You've got to slow that down somehow, right? Maybe they need to be a little more aggressive. Maybe a few more pressures towards the quarterback.
First down 10 at their own 29-yard line.
Rodgers will bring the pack up with a first and 10, just shy of the 30. Off play action, he'll throw to start the drive.
Oh, the Buccaneer pressure too much. Down he goes.
Dan Buchanan. Credit him with a sack, and it goes as a loss of 6. After the sack on first down, Rodgers. And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
Incomplete. It's third down.
On that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. To throw, it's Rodgers. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by LeBron. And now look at this. Big game, but a fumble. But this will get out of bounds, so possession will stay the same.
Intercepted. The Bucs take over first and 10 at the 16-yard line.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Jones, and he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run.
Check.
operating from the gun. Brady, and he hauls it in for the Buccaneer touchdown. Tom Brady to his old Patriot pal, Rob Gronkowski. And the Bucs are going to add on to their lead.
For the point after.
You got to figure down by the goal line. This is where a tight end earns his money, in the high traffic area. And he's able to work free in the middle of the end zone and grabs that one for a touchdown.
Extra point put through by Saka. And it's now 14-0.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25.
5 yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. They're staring at a two-touchdown deficit, 14-0 to score as they regroup with first and 10. Looking to find a lane, but he can't rein in at the line of scrimmage.
Brought down by Levante Baker.
They had to run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on second and 10.
At the 25-yard line.
Rodgers now to throw. And Rodgers is going to go down. He's sacked. The sack by the Super Bowl champion and Pro Bowler Jason Pierre-Paul. On third and long, it's Rodgers. Gets this to his running back, Aaron Jones. And they'll get him down here at the 23. That one good for only 6, and it leaves him with a fourth down. Now look at this, 4th and 12, and they're going to line up to go for
it.
They do go for it. It's Rodgers. Got a man. It's Tanyan complete. And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49. A gain of 26 and a conversion there as well on fourth down.
First down.
Inches here.
Field on the tackle.
They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway.
At the 41-yard line.
On second down, Williams. And a nice run. They're going to take this close to the first down marker at the Bucs 35. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
A gain of 7.
2 minutes to play. First half, it's 14-0. Time rolls around. Jonathan Coachman will have all the highlights and analysis of this first half of play from our studios in Orlando. First down and much more here for Jones. And finally wrestled down at the 8-yard line.
Aaron Jones.
A good pickup there. 26 yards.
8-yard line.
Well, these guys have definitely been outplayed in the first half. I like their countenance. I like the way that they haven't panicked out there, the way they're carrying themselves. They're starting to move the ball. And what you have to do, maintain your poise and start to put together some drives.
This is first and goal and a golden chance to get a score back here before halftime. Now Jones. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard that time. Second and goal. The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on second and goal.
Brings up second and goal at the 7-yard line.
They'll try again with Jones. And just shy of the goal line as he's out of bounds right at the one. A nice run there as he picks up six. It's going to be third and goal now. So now things get interesting on third and goal from the one.
This almost becomes a Darwinian call, doesn't it? Almost survival of the fittest here. I know we can go all cliche. I'll go ahead and do it. Who wants it more here? Who has a better leverage at the line of scrimmage? Let's go and see what happens.
We'll try to run it in with Jones. And Jones is not going to have the first down as they stop him short. No gain on the play. And what to do now on fourth and goal?
Fourth and goal at the 1 yard line.
Take this into the end zone for a Green Bay touchdown. Taking it in from a yard out. And the Packers are back within a score. The way this one was going, you just got the sense they needed something before half. They've at least got something on the board now. Still trailing, but a good sign.
That takes me back to our preseason tour of NFL camps. You remember we talked with that one coach who said his emphasis this year was scoring in the last 2 minutes of a half, heading into the locker room. This hits it right there. Take that momentum, take that good feeling, and take it to the locker room, regroup, and start over. They got it here.
They did indeed. And a lot of football, full half to be played.
Mason Crosby, the kickoff for Green Bay.
Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he won't quite make it to the 25.
Pickens on the return. The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 24-yard line.
The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. You've got less than 30 seconds left here in the half. You're well on your own side of the field. What are we doing here, Coach Davis?
Well, I'm trying something on first down. And it's
looking for Evans, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Jair Alexander. And he's giving his guys a shot for late points as they will take over in range for a field goal or maybe more.
At the 25-yard line.
Taken.
Complete.
Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see.
Brings up second and 3 at the 18-yard line.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3. Shotgun now for Rodgers. And that will be incomplete. 4 ticks left here on the clock.
Intended for Devontae Adams. Incomplete. It's third down.
And with just 4 seconds left in this first half, a timeout call.
kick it. People acting different, so I asked, can I?
So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. From the right hash, it's a 35-yard attempt. So that'll back him up 5. So with 4 seconds to go in the half, here's the field goal unit onto the field. From the right hash, this from an even 40 yards out. And the 13-year man puts it through, and that will do it for this first half. So we've hit intermission. It's halftime. This is the NFL, and it's a presentation of EA Sports. All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. The Packers set to get the football first, and they are trailing on the scoreboard as we resume action, ready for the third quarter. That's fielded on the back line of the end zone. Ready to get their next drive underway. And last time, able to get 3. That's not what they wanted. They wanted 6, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
Number 33, just, Aaron Jones. I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for 6. Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. They'll keep it on the ground. Jones. And they work this well upfield across the 45. That one, a gain of 20 and a first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Now a first down carry by Jones. He'll get 3 up to midfield.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that field and like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
And a nice run. They're going to take this close to the first down marker at the Bucks 41.
Well, that was a unit that understood exactly where the first down marker was, handed it to their guy who could run it, created some space, and he got there.
After the run by Jones, here's 1st and 10. Now they try the right side here. And he's going to get this down near the 30-yard line. 11 yards and a Green Bay Packer first down.
All right, I got to ask you, with these RPOs, essentially the quarterback has 3 options, right? So what's different from that versus the triple option that we see the service academies run at the college level?
As a general rule, the triple option at the college level, most things are called outside of the quarterback faking it to the runner and then keeping it himself and maybe having a trail back. What I mean is, in the NFL, that option to throw the football all comes about organically. It's a natural deal based on reads. In college, if you're going to throw the football off a triple option, you've actually called that play.
They're going to take this close to the first down marker at the Bucks 19-yard line. It's a 7-yard gain there, and it's good enough to move the chains.
7. First down, Green Bay.
All runs on this drive so far. It's 1st and 10. Rodgers throwing quickly out to Adams. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. And despite the completion, they're going to wind up losing three there. Second down. To Adams on the perimeter. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone. That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be third down. Working from the gun, Rodgers. He goes right back to Adams. That's complete. They get 10 there, but it leaves him just short for fourth down.
A pickup of 10, but it brings up fourth down.
They'll go with Jones, and he gets the first down yardage he needs before he's brought down at the 6. A solid pickup of 5 and a very solid fourth down conversion, and defensively, pure frustration. So a moment to catch our collective breath after the fourth down conversion. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's going to take it in. Touchdown, Packers.
Touchdown, Green Bay.
Aaron Jones, his second touchdown of the night. And the Packers have taken the lead. Great call to hand that one off, and his running back did the rest.
Someone read their keys correctly, and on the defensive side of the ball, they certainly did not, because they really essentially were just going to swarm the quarterback. They kind of guessed themselves out of the play, and guess who benefited? The guy with the football.
Mason.
Now after the touchdown, here's Crosby to kick it away. Takes this about 5 yards deep, and no effort to bring this one out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Offense set to begin their next possession. And now they'll look to answer working from behind. And remember, this offense has sputtered, yet to score here in the second half. They'll need to change that here. Here's a good way to kick off a drive, complete over the middle. And they work this well upfield across the 45. For 23 yards, the final tally. The gun, Brady. There's the Penn State man. It's Chris Godwin, and he takes it down deep into enemy territory.
Buccaneers,
a big play that time for Tampa Bay. 48 yards
at the 4-yard line.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown, and that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about 3.
Short of the goal line.
But a spotlight hit him once already tonight as he got into the end zone. He was trying to make it a double spotlight, wasn't he?
But credit the defense, bottling him up, not letting him get in for the second score there. Take the lead.
For the point after.
It's up and good to make it 21-17.
Good. Makes the score Buccaneers 21, Packers 17. Bradley Pinion, the kick.
the touchdown. Now it's Bradley Pinion on to kick this one away. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28.
On the return, the Packers take over first and 10 at their own 28-yard line.
The Packer offense ready to get their next drive underway. And that last drive, it was all about the ground game, ground and pound.
And I don't care how we're playing the game these days, offensive linemen still want to fire out and smack the guy opposite them and move the football on the ground. They feel better about that. That's what they want to do. That's how they want to play, and that's how they got it done.
Yeah, they got it for a touchdown last drive. Let's see what happens here. This has been all that we'd hoped for. Two of the game's all-time great QBs slugging it out in a one-score game here in the second half. First and 10. And Jones with a nice burst there on first down as he'll be taken down, but not before a gain of 7 yards.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
A good run, got 7 on first. Here's 2nd and 3. They stay on the ground this time. It's Williams. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
They were not fooling around at all, were they? 2nd and short, and they brought out the heavy package. Almost felt like the super heavy package against that defense, didn't it?
Yeah, I don't think they expected that much beef up front, and it turned into an easy first down conversion. On first down, it's Jones. And he'll get maybe a couple before he's taken down, as that will take us to the 2-minute warning. So it's Packer football here as we welcome you back. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They'll go again to Jones. Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with 3rd down coming up.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
This is out quickly to the right. The completion there lines up a wash, and it'll bring up 4th down. Down 4 late. Got to go for it here on 4th down.
Now 4th down.
They'll go for it. It's Rodgers. And it's going to be batted down. And we'll go the other way with the football. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And the Buccaneers defense holds, and they get the football back. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And this game not quite in hand yet. We'll likely see all 3 timeouts defensively and then reassess where we are. To throw is Brady. He finds his tight end Howard. That's complete. The Packers going to use one of their timeouts as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming 2nd down play.
2nd and 8 at the 39-yard line.
So 2nd and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on 1st down. Give to Jones. And he'll be stopped right at midfield. 11 yards. yards there. First down. Great time there to come up with his longest run of the night. We just saw
leads to a lot of satisfaction because if they're able to hang on and win this game, you know what else will happen in the locker room after this?
What's that?
Head coach will step up and go, great job, guys. Because of that, come in a little bit later tomorrow.
Get him down as he's inside the 40. Now the Packers going to go ahead and use the second of their timeouts as they get it with 26 seconds to go in the football game. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Here's Jones. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42.
On the tackle.
Now the Packers going to burn their third and final timeout as the clock stops with 23 seconds to go in the game. Got to figure the rush is going to be fierce again as they come up second and 13. Brady will take a knee here, and that should just about do it.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
So time has run out on what will be a Tampa Bay victory. And it wasn't really always pretty. They had their bumps and bruises, really both sides did, but they did what they needed to do at home to get the win.
Yeah, they really had to grind this one out, didn't they? Because nothing came easy. Every snap was a major league brawl. They had to win at the line of scrimmage, win downfield. They got all those things accomplished. But to win a close one like this, you know, every team wants to be physical. We've heard that a million times, right? But those who are mentally tough, those are the teams that you have to deal with in the playoffs. This was that type of a game.
put it on me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top of it. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of I got both my girls head to toe designer. Drill, little bit, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. I can't hear the hate, got a lot of it. Take these bands to the bank, let them rot in it. So much ice on me, I wish I had two necks. I got homies that can sleep without two. I got homies that can sleep without. Gucci and Chanel, I got a lot of it. Walk up in the spot like, hey, what poppin' in? Gon' pop it for me, cause I'm rich and poppin' in. Yeah. Drill, little bit, little bit. Let me feel myself a little bit. Little bit, little bit. You ain't talking big. Get out my way, little bit. She gon' put it on me, that's a lot of it. Four coupes, four seasons, drop the top a bit. Bust down, but my wrist, time to talk a lot of. I got both my girls head to toe designer.
The NFL is on EA Sports, and we're at Raymond James Stadium in Tampa, Florida. Just a short time ago, the Buccaneers emerging from their tunnel to the roar of this frenzied crowd here in the Sunshine State. And we're in the big ship, and fittingly, everyone here ready to do battle as Tampa Bay gets ready to match up with the Buffalo Bills. Tyler Bass about ready to get us going. And off we go from Tampa. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee. Maybe a yard shy of there at the 24.
At their own 24-yard line.
Man, and he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five
at the 29-yard line.
Between the tackles, that's a little deflating for a defense, isn't it?
It really is, because that's where your strength's supposed to be. You're supposed to be in a spot where they can't make that yardage there. You're supposed to send them outside. Not in this case.
They'll run on first down. It's Jones. They'll get only a couple down to 44.
Brandon, we talk all the time about those hybrid players, guys who can do more than one thing. And I think if you play strong safety in the NFL today, you are a true hybrid. Part linebacker, part cover guy.
And coming up, sticking his nose in the mess there and making a nice play defensively.
What's the motion?
from the 44. Brady. That's complete. It's Chris Godwin. And he'll go down here at the 35-yard line. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the playbook, but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
49, 49, guys. Mike, 49. Check it, reload. Check 43. Switch.
On first down, Jones. And not much running room. Down to the 32.
Tremaine
Edmonds there to bring him down.
Vision is so important for the man in the middle because his ability to look through all the clutter that's happening in front of him, diagnose a play, and then go make it and finish it, that's when the great ones know that they have the goods.
And he's got a first down as a tackle made at the Bills' 15-yard line. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Jones. And he goes backwards here, losing yardage back to the 16. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
His throw caught at about the 5. And the Buccaneers are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the 5. First down, Tampa's Brady hooks up with Howard. Now Brady. And he's got his tight end, Howard. It's a Buccaneer touchdown. A 5-yard touchdown catch. And the Bucs take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. They gotta love that. 9-play drive results in 6 points.
That means they're doing the dictating. That means that they've described how the game's going to go. They're playing at their tempo, at their pace. If you're on the other side of the ball, if you're playing defense, defense is not methodical. They've got to go in there and shake things up and create a little havoc.
Bradley Pinion to kick off for Tampa Bay.
Now Pinion with the kickoff honors following the touchdown. Now this will make it into the end zone. And he will be taken down here as the first quarter of play will come to an end. After 1-7-0 on EA Sports. Allen and the Bills now with a first and 10 at their own 19-yard line. Here's Devin Singletary. He played in this state at Florida Atlantic. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down.
Jordan White.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. And what I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
On second down, here's a run with Singletary. And this time he's not going anywhere. He'll get him down right at the line of scrimmage. Right, no gain on the play, and now they're faced with a third and one.
And it's third down.
They'll try and run for this with Singletary. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 12 yards that time, and a Bills first down.
Plenty of things to talk about here, partner, but to me, their defense gave up a touchdown on the first drive. How about how they're responding, coming back? That's a big third down pickup to keep their drive alive.
On play action, Allen. Forced out to his left. And he's going to keep it here. Nothing open downfield. He keeps it himself for 11 and a first down.
Man, defensively, that hurts. They got him out of his rhythm. They had him hemmed in, but somehow he was able to tuck it away and get away for a gain.
They'll run on first down with Singletary. A short gain of just over 2 yards as the first half clock dips inside of 3 minutes.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense? What's that, 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. The last run got 3. Now here's 2nd and 7. Allen going to give this one to Singletary. Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to 3rd down. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense the next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
A good chance. This is 4-down territory if they're unable to convert. But right now looking at a 3rd and 3. 2 minutes on the clock, 2nd quarter, 7-0 ball game. We remind you that coming up in 2 minutes' time, we'll hand you off to Orlando, where Jonathan Coachman will have highlights and analysis in his first half of action. Down as they convert on 3rd and 3 with a nice gain of 7 yards. Allen to Beasley, 1st down, Buffalo. To the air, Allen. They'll run the screen with Moss. And he is out of bounds inside the 30.
Allen's pass.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
Able to get 7 on that 1st down pass play. 2nd and 3. So the shotgun snap to Allen. And he's got his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a 1st down.
1st down, Buffalo.
This is Singletary. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. 10 yards, good enough for a Buffalo 1st down.
It's a gain of 10. And the Bills 1st down.
They'll run here with Singletary. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 seconds to go in the first half of play. A chance now to get even before the break as they come up 1st and goal. They'll look to run with Morris. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further.
The ball carrier.
No gain on the play that time, and it sets up 2nd and goal. And they'll get him down just shy of the goal line at about the 1.
The ball carrier.
Now the Bills will use the 2nd of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number 1. This Tampa Bay defense, they held strong on the first 2 plays. Now 3rd and goal. Singletary. He's not going to get there. That won't even be close. It was blown up. up in the backfield. Now here's a timeout as they're going to get it with 8 seconds remaining here in the first half. So they won't get a touchdown, but here's a chance to at least get three to end the first half. This is less than an extra point, just a 19-yard attempt. So a late three there, and that'll help as they head into the break.
Talk about situational football and something they've worked out since the OTAs and minicamps the previous summer. They take care of the ball, get 3 points, knowing they're going to get the ball to start the second half. That's the old two-for-one special to finish things off.
This is taken just shy of the 10.
Jadon Mickens on the return. The Bucs take over first and 10 at their own 23-yard line.
So time perhaps for one final kneel down before they take this lead to the locker room. All that remains is to snap this once, and that'll do it for the first half of play. That's it for the first half. Two more quarters to go. We'll have plenty more to see after the break. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. The Bills trail here, but they will get the football first as we are back underway on EA Sports. Fielded in the end zone. Start their next drive. And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally, because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
And they're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal. Singletary here running out of the gun, and he'll be brought down right around the 37. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
On first down, they stick with Singletary. And that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. 2 yards the loss, second and 12.
I remember one thing I was lousy at growing up, track and field. I could never anticipate the start before a race, but how about that backer? He figured it out, jumped the count, and turned it into a really nice play for his defense.
The quick throw taken in by Diggs. And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. They get 11 back on that one. It leads to third down.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
On third down, they go with Singletary. And he's got a first down as he's up to the 48. Give him 2 yards on that play, and the Bills will move the chains.
First down, Buffalo.
On the move to his left, and now he's going to use his legs. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short game.
On second down now, Singletary, and he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
Fourth down.
fourth down.
And my goodness, this is incomplete. The Bills' drive stalls out on fourth down. And the Buccaneers' defense holds and they get the football back.
It's a turnover on down.
Offense set to begin their next possession. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. They'll start out on the ground with Jones. And a minimal gain here as he's up to about the 47-yard line.
Oliver made the tackle.
Early down stuff to put this offense in a precarious position. We know that securing the point of attack, especially against the big-bodied guys in the middle of this D, has got to be priority one.
Brady going to fake the give to Jones and set up to throw. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A first down there on a pickup of 25. A nice shot there, Charles. They picked up the blitz, were able to complete the pass.
That had the total feel of a quarterback in control. Red blitz, got him into the right protection scheme, so he doesn't get hit back there. He's got a chance to step up with supreme confidence and deliver it downfield with a nice completion.
And he'll be brought down at what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. Back now in Tampa. It's the Bucs. They've got the football. They also are in front here on the scoreboard as we start the fourth. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Shotgun now for Brady. This into the hands of his running back, Ronald Jones. Down he goes at the 23, a pickup of 4. That's a gain of 4 here in the fourth quarter, with them leading by 4 on the scoreboard. Third down, here's Jones. And they're going to mark him down short, maybe by about a yard, if that. It's a gain of 5, and now the question, will the offense stay out there on fourth and 1?
It's now fourth down and 1.
And no move to get the offense off the field. They'll stay put on fourth and 1. They'll go with a big back foot in. And they are going to stop him on fourth and 1 as they'll wind up going backwards. Leonard Fournette stops short of the marker on fourth down. And the Bills are going to get the football back. The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And can they take advantage? Their defense got the fourth down stop, and now they're hoping to find the end zone. Their field goal wouldn't be enough to erase this fourth quarter. And down he goes, a Buccaneer sack. Shaquille Barrett put that sack by his name in the stat sheet.
It's second down.
Another try after the first down sack. Allen. Incomplete, almost intercepted. They haven't picked him off yet. Would have been a great time for the first, but instead it's third down.
It's third down and 14.
Out of the shotgun. Here's Allen. And able to catch it on the left sideline, but they're going to rule him out of bounds. So it'll be incomplete. Certainly one they'd like to have back as it brings up fourth down.
It's fourth down.
We
They're going to go for it here on fourth down.
54.
One final try here for Allen. It's brought incomplete. It's John Brown. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. How about them biting off 15 yards there on the fourth down attempt and keeping the drive alive? From the 32 now, here's first and 10. They'll run on first down. Singletary, and he's going to have a Bills first down as good running gets him to about the 44. Josh Allen, he says that he wants to continue to perfect executing the run-pass option. Looked pretty good there.
And he's put in the minds of all people trying to defend him that his legs create big plays. So guess who benefits?
His running back.
No doubt about it, and we just saw it there.
So it's Bills football here as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. It's a first down and a gain of 10.
It's a gain of 10. First down.
First down. Singletary.
5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
Here's Singletary. After a gain of 5, they'll wind up being about a length of the football short here on third down.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. They'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
On third down, Singletary. And down inside the 15 he goes. Now the Bills are going to use the first of their timeouts as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in the fourth. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. Singletary, and he'll be taken down here at about the 11. Give him a couple on the carry there. Second and 8. To throw is Allen. Now he's got it. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. They'll give him 8 on the play, and they'll be faced with a third and inches. Now the Bucs going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave him with 2 remaining. We'll be back after this. They had the catch on second down, but it didn't help at all. And now they're looking at third down here. Now Ronnie Singletary. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down. As he's tackled at the 1.
First and goal at the 1-yard line.
Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Here with Singletary, and he's across for the late touchdown, and in the final seconds, that one should just about put a capper on this game.
So for those of little faith, guess what? It got done. They now have the lead with that touchdown this late in the contest. I wonder if that was a play they were holding or a play that they just knew would work from past experience.
I just saw it in their eyes on the sideline before starting that last drive, and they did. You're right. They got it done. Looks like they're going to be the winners. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away.
Taken in the end zone.
And with time a factor here late, he'll just take a knee and they'll put it out to the 25. Offense ready to get their drive started. So you're right there, but obviously the clock is not your friend. How do you handle this situation?
You're thinking two plays. One, to get yourself in position for the second one, whether you're able to get into field goal range or you have to try another deep pass, another Hail Mary, but you're trying to get the first one to a receiver, get out of bounds, and give yourself a chance to set things up for an easier shot at it.
We'll see if they can do it. Might be easier said than done. An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. He's back to throw. And they work this well upfield across the 45. And we will get a timeout with two ticks left.
First and 10 at the 47-yard line.
Try now for Brady. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And it's incomplete. So their final drive comes up empty. And with that, the ball game is over.
Buccaneers.
Well, going into the final play of this game, they knew that they needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.
For Charles Davis and all our crew, I'm Brandon Gaudin. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we bid you good night from Tampa.
We'll be right back. pick it and go. Yeah, you just step on.